If you're in search of a make-ahead mashed potato recipe with a buttery, creamy interior that gets crispy on the outside, then these Dutchess potatoes are for you. I'm Whitney from SweetCayenne.com, and by the end of this video, you're gonna learn how to make the most heavenly potatoes that you can bake in a dish, pipe into swirls, or spoon into nets that will hold all of that delicious gravy. To get started, you're gonna need 2.5 pounds of Yukon Gold potatoes that are peeled and cut into pieces of similar size. You want them to be as similar in size as possible so that they cook at the same rate. To get potatoes to cook evenly, it's recommended that you put them in a pot of cold water and then bring the water to a boil as the potatoes are in the pot. This cooks them perfectly from the inside out and makes sure that the potatoes have an even doneness all the way through. Once your potatoes are on the stovetop over high heat, add about 2 to 3 tablespoons of salt to the cooking water to flavor them from the inside out. After they've boiled for about 20 minutes, pierce them with the tip of a paring knife and make sure that it easily goes through the potato. While the potatoes are boiling, use a small saucepan to melt 3 tablespoons of butter into 1/4 cup of heavy cream over low heat. You'll add 1 teaspoon of salt, 1/4 teaspoon of pepper, and 2 sprigs of fresh thyme to steep in the cream as the butter is melting. Once it's melted, remove it from the heat and let the thyme steep in it for about 10 minutes.
Okay, so our potatoes are fork tender and I've drained them and they're steaming off right here. And then I have our buttercream mixture and it is pretty cool. The thyme has been steeping in it and so I'm just going to fish that out. Just real quickly. All right, and then we have 3 egg yolks that you can see I've cracked into this bowl. And so what we're gonna do is slowly add the cream in a steady stream while whisking it into the egg yolks so that it doesn't cook them. Now this cream and butter mixture is already pretty cool, so I'm not too worried about it. You just wanna make sure that you're whisking the entire time and adding the cream and butter a little bit at a time. So I'm gonna tell you about an amazing tool for making mashed potatoes that are super creamy all the way throughout with no lumps, and it is a potato ricer. I don't know if you've ever seen one of these before, but there's holes in the bottom and you press the potatoes through a few at a time and it makes them perfectly creamy, almost as if you had pureed them in the food processor or with a potato meal. So I will link in the description box the ricer I have below, and you should definitely check them out and get one before the Thanksgiving season. So you just plop that down and then push the potatoes right through those holes at the bottom, and it will make your potatoes perfectly and smooth.
When all the potatoes are riced, you'll pour in your egg cream mixture, followed by 1/2 cup of freshly grated Parmesan cheese, and then you'll use a rubber spatula to gently fold all of that together until it's well incorporated, smooth, and creamy.
Now that our potato mixture is ready to go, we have a couple of options for how we want to bake them up. So the first option, and this is the easiest, would be to put your potato mixture in a greased baking dish and bake it just like that. Now, if you're making these ahead of time, you can prepare them in the baking dish and then pop them in the fridge until you're ready to bake. They bake at 425 for 25 to 30 minutes until they're hot all the way through and golden brown on the outside. So you just want to smooth the tops so that it's nice and smooth, just like that. And then what I like to do is take a fork and kind of do a little design on the top, because we're going to put melted butter and Parmesan cheese over this and it's gonna give it some nice crispy edges on the outside. So you just want to kind of crisscross with a fork before you put the butter and the cheese on top. Once the baking dish is ready, you can brush a little bit of melted butter or olive oil on top of the potatoes, followed by a quarter cup of freshly grated Parmesan cheese. The second option for your Duchess potatoes is to get a spoon and then put them onto mounds on a baking sheet lined with parchment paper. This would be the next to most easiest option. So once you've got a mound on there, you may have to use your fingers to get it off the spoon. You're just going to make a little indentation, just like that, kind of like a bird's nest. And that is what will hold all your gravy once these are baked. So I've got a fun tip for you also right here. At this point, you could put all your bird's nests out onto the baking sheet and then pop this in the freezer. Freeze it for about an hour, and then you can take these and put them in a freezer safe Ziploc bag and store them until ready to use. You can bake them from frozen on a baking sheet just like this, so you've got mashed potatoes ready whenever the craving hits. And then for option three, you can pipe the potatoes onto the baking sheet with a pastry bag and a star tip. In order to do this though, you're going to have to add some additional half and half or cream to the potato mixture so that it's soft enough to pipe through the piping tip. And when I learned how to make these in culinary school, we piped them through the piping bag because it looks fancy and extra special. So the easiest way to fill a piping bag is to fold down like the top third of it and then open it up with your hands and use the spatula to scoop it in.
Carefully pipe the potatoes into a swirled mound, starting from the outside and working your way in. You'll finish up by brushing them with some melted butter or olive oil and then with a sprinkling of freshly grated Parmesan cheese. I've got the oven heated to 425 and we're gonna bake these until they're golden brown and slightly crispy on top. The Duchess potatoes are hot out of the oven and I cannot tell you how incredible they smell. They smell buttery and kind of cheesy from the Parmesan on top and I cannot wait to take a bite. They're perfectly crispy on the outside, tender and creamy on the inside, and piping hot. Wow, those are to die for. Let me take another bite. Perfect, just what you want in a buttery mashed potato. These taste so good with my mini meatloaf recipe, so I'll list that in the description box below for you, where you'll find everything you need to make this recipe, including a printable version. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, I'd love it if you leave a comment below to say hello and tell me where you're from. Be sure to subscribe to the channel so that you never miss a recipe. Thanks again, and I'll see you in the next video.